This was my second train ride of the night. The way it started didn't promise anything better than the last one. Freezing wind tearing at my face like sandpaper and razors, ice hard and slick under my hands and feet. And somewhere in the background, the wail of sirens, the city howling after me. New York sped by and fast forward, dark rooftop water towers and a dead forest of antennas and chimneys, all a blur. When the train he was riding slowed down, Gagniti made his move.
It's Payne! He's coming down the stairs! Shoot the bastard!
Okay, boss. You got it.
No problem.
Hey!
Yo!
Payne has nowhere left to go. We are very close to capturing him. You'll get a full statement then. Right now, I've got better things to do, ma'am.
That was Deputy Chief Jim Bravura from the NYPD with no further comment at this time.
Apart from his suspicious food habits, I figured Bravura to be one of the good guys. Fate had just dropped us on different sides in this. But when it came to capturing me, he was way out of his league. I had already ditched the cops a couple of rooftops back. For now. Gogniti ran out of steam in a dead-end alley with steam boiling out of the sewer grates like all the fires of hell were burning high beneath us. It was shakedown time. Where's Lupino?
Screw you!
Bad start, Vinny.
Ah! Police brutality!
I rate pretty high on that.
You can't just hurt me in cold blood?
Just keep telling yourself that. Listen good, Candyman. I'm not gonna be anybody's fall guy. I wanna know where your boss is hiding. There was no glory in this. I hadn't asked for this crap. Trouble had come to me in big dark swarms. The good and the just were like gold dust in the city. I had no illusions. I was not one of them. I was no hero. Just me and the gun and the crook. My options had decreased to a singular course.
I'll tell you, just don't hurt me no more. Lupino's at Ragnarok, the nightclub. Book me, take me in, haul me to the freaking jail, just don't hurt me.
Your rights will be read at your funeral.